Hello, my name is Omar Abisad. It's Thursday, April 5th, 2018 at 2:40 p.m. in Toronto. So I'm going to talk a little bit about the more recent happenings around my building and the constant submissions for warrants and writs and so on to get me out of here, basically. There is a person out the window that I filed a claim against, who's constantly making comments about this ongoing community targeting program in which he's taken part. So there is a comment that is constantly being said, and that is the cops, two cops, already confirmed and verified that I used to be a prostitute. Now, whether this is true or not, whether he's using this strategy to, in using these comments to say that cops said this and the cops said that to terrorize me, I'm not sure. I don't know. So I'm going to make a statement about what I heard and what he's repeating over and over and over. And he's calling the name Slip over and over again. I'm going to say this in response to that. I'm not a prostitute. I never have been a prostitute. I don't intend to become one ever in my lifetime or in 10 lifetimes to come. It is actually something I am fighting against as part of women's rights issues. So this is not something that I would do. If, and I'm going to reiterate, if there are any members of the Toronto Police Force, or any police force for that matter, who are verifying that I used to be a prostitute, or I am a prostitute, this is not true. What is being verified is not true. And I've been saying this for years, and I've been going to the 42nd Division complaining that men are stalking me, neighbors are stalking me, neighbors' sons are stalking me. Prostitutes don't do this. I have it on a record in emails, visits to 5 police stations, saying that men are stalking me. Prostitutes don't do this. If there are any members of the Toronto Police Force verifying that I am a prostitute, used to be a prostitute, this is an out-and-out lie. Now, why would somebody, a policeman or anybody else for that matter, verify that I am a prostitute when I'm not? Well, there is a very good answer for that. The answer is that they are part of a trafficking ring. This is the only reason that somebody would do this. And that includes any people in my family. The only reason that they would do this is to take part in a trafficking ring or a sex slave operation. Anybody, including people in my workplace, who are predicating that he thinks I'm a prostitute, these are traffickers. These are traffickers. And the comments are repeated over and over again. I was found in a drain by a policeman. This has never happened. If any policeman is saying this, this is a lie. It's a contrived and made up fake record in the file. I am a target. These things are done. So that's not a surprise to me. However, if it's in the file and a policeman says this, it lends credibility. Because I hear from a member of my family, not blood related, who say, it's been verified. The cops are saying that you're a prostitute. So they believe what the cops are saying when I'm not. So the cops, the family is targeting me and taking part in the community targeting program because they believe it's the right thing to do. Because the cops are behind it, because they've verified already that I am a prostitute, which is not true. I never have been a prostitute. I'm not one now. Prostitutes don't report their johns to the cops. They don't report that they're being stalked by pimps and johns over and over again for years. Now, as to why the cops are saying I'm mentally ill when I do report that I'm being stalked, but if they are verifying that I'm a prostitute at the same time and telling me I'm mentally ill when I say I'm being stalked, that's a very, very interesting scenario right there. So if any cops who are submitting information to get charges and warrants and writs and whatever to judges and magistrates, the evidence, quote unquote, that's being presented by these people are fake evidence. They're contrived evidence. It's not true. It's not true. It's one-sided, deliberately one-sided. And it's based on suppressing my voice, which is why I'm doing this YouTube video. I have never been a prostitute. If any evidence are being presented that quote-unquote confirms and quote-unquote verifies that I used to be one, this is contrived evidence, and it's one-sided. I'm not there to defend myself. And it's used to justify. It doesn't have to be proven beyond a reasonable doubt. It has to be justified. That's all. It doesn't have to stand up to any strict test of credibility and truthfulness. It just has to be justifiable. So this is my side of the story for that submission that's being made by whoever it is that's making it, including a cop, if that's true, if the cop is doing it, if a cop is doing it. I am not a prostitute, never have been. The information is not true. The information that's being submitted, if it is, you hear me swearing inside of my home, this is not mental illness. It's not an indication of mental illness. It's a result, a direct result of being criminally harassed for years. This is not mental, permanent, any permanent condition. It's definitely not a mental illness. It's a reaction to being criminally harassed. Anger has to be vented out of the system, because when somebody is criminally harassed, of course, your anger is provoked, deliberately so, and that is a crime as well. Your anger is deliberately incited. That anger has to be taken care of in a constructive way. Venting is one way to do that. And if I swear in the process, then so be it. My therapist says to do it. This is my side of the story. And if any Toronto police are saying they don't know my side of the story, they're lying. Because I sent a lot of emails saying that I'm being stalked by men. Prostitutes don't go to the cops saying Johns are stalking them. They don't take people to the Human Rights Tribunal for sexual harassment. So there is no mental illness, and there should be no writs if there are writs being sought. And there is no public discourse, because the only reason I'm doing this is because I'm criminally harassed. My life is in danger. I'm in fear of the Toronto police based on my past experience with them, and I have a reason, really good reason to be. The only way I can defend myself is on the YouTube, as I'm doing right now. So this shouldn't be taken and used against me. There is no mental illness, and there is no criminal activity. All the claims of criminal activity is because I'm being targeted. I am a target. My name has been put on the list to be targeted, therefore I am targeted. Lied upon. So there shouldn't be any writ. However, if there is one, please feel free to serve me so I can have a voice and I can defend myself. And I can bring all the evidence I have against the perpetrators who is committing these crimes against me. Talk to you another time.